What's up, divas? And what's up, divos? It's your girl, April. So you guys already know what time it is. It's Real Talk Wednesday, and this is where we just dish out the tea and give advice. So yes, hunties, yes. So I think my camera looks like it's kind of like lopsided, slanted. So let's fix that. Okay, so yeah, that's totally better. So in case you guys are wondering about the hair that I'm rocking, this is my old hair from Nubian Bar, and this is the Kinky Straight in color tint number 10, and I did do some customization to this unit prior to me making it, which was darkening the roots. As you see, the color was all just one shade, but I needed some dark roots because I don't really go outside with blonde roots, especially because my hair is not blonde. So I wanted like some darker roots. So I did that in the closure part as well as the roots of the bundles. Well, throughout the whole entire closure, so I could just part it wherever I want. So for the hair, it is kinky straight, and I did flat iron it and make it silky straight. And it seemed like ever since I went and washed it, it just doesn't get as kinky as it first did, which is annoying the fuck out of me because I really did like this hair, but now it doesn't seem to get as kinky as it originally did. And let me tell you, I did flat iron it, and once I flat ironed it, I washed it, and I don't know, the texture is not like it was the first time. And it is, of course, human hair. So I don't know. But anyway, other than that, I still do like it. It's just that it's not as textured as it first was. And as for the makeup look, I wore some purple lipstick today, which is from ColourPop. It's the Ultra Matte Liquid lipsticks, which I love the ultra matte ones. And I do have on the color Lumiere 2 and Koala. Now, I'm saying I'm wearing the color purple like that because my girl, Miss Shay Love, we are always on the phone. She calls me on her lunch break. She calls me when she gets home. I call her all day long. Her lunch breaks are supposed to be an hour, but whatever. We are, girl, me and you know that they are longer than an hour. But either way, we was talking last night on the phone, and she was like, girl, I already know what color lipstick you're going to put on in any video. It's always pink. And it's not like a bright fuchsia pink. It's like a nude pale pink. She just got me pegged. And she's so right. I don't know what it is, but I really do love the color pink. And it's always like this very light pink. But she loves the color purple, so that's her signature color. And I had to tell her, you know, like in the movie Steel Magnolias with Julia Roberts, how her whole wedding was nothing but pink. And she said, that is my signature color. And that is my signature color for lips. So I promised her that I would do purple. And I said, is there any particular color purple that you want me to put on? She was like, no, just put on anything but damn pink. So I wore purple today just for her. And I mixed them together. And this is for you, Shay. Okay? So check out her channel. I will post it below. She is like the best on YouTube. She needs more subscribers because her attitude is so bubbly, and I think she really is deserving of it. So make sure you check her out and subscribe to her videos. Let her know that I sent you guys over there. That is my good friend, and she is in Texas, and babies, she's showing me these houses out there that I might just be packing up and moving to Texas, okay? For real. So, other than that, as far as my online dating goes, I did meet someone really, really special. This has been like 2 weeks now. And I'll talk about him more in futuristically because, you know, we got to fill the motherfucker out. But he is really, really cute. He's got like these gorgeous grayish blue eyes. He's my age, so, and we are both Geminis, which is awesome. He is taller than me, not by much, but he is taller than me. And of course, he got some swag. He's so cute. Yes, he is so cute, and he's a gentleman, and he's just really, really sweet. So I will talk about him in a later video, okay? So because, you know, I gotta fill him out, but I will definitely talk about him. But for the online other sites, oh my God, there are so many like weirdos out there. I just want to read you some of the messages for like Match.com. I get like loads of messages, and first of all, I really don't deal with a lot of them. I just don't reply back to, because it's like, hold the fuck up, like chill out a little bit. So like, you have one, you know, you send a message and it's basically like, stunning, who are you and where have you been, with this huge smiley face, like, okay, seriously, who are you and where have you been? Let's just be realistic. You're not about to win me over with this bullshit. Like, you know, like, really? Okay, thanks for calling me stunning. But I really don't need the extra bullshit. There are some guys on here that, you know, they leave their phone number. You know, you try to be polite to them and send them a message back just to be polite. You know, because they say things like, you have a beautiful profile picture. Nice meeting you on here. My name is such and such. Here is my number. But I don't really try to lead you on. I basically like, nice to meet you. Happy Sunday, or enjoy your 4th of July. That's it. If you tell me your name, then I will tell you mine. But I just am trying to be a polite person. And then, you know, when you seem like you're being a little bit too polite, or just in general polite, they give you your number and they give you their number, and you're like, well, let's meet up later this week so we can go out for drinks. Send me a text message or leave me your number. So, you know, I have to be like, I'm sorry, I'm not sure what made you think I would like to meet with you. I don't know you, and I was actually being polite by returning your message, but no, thank you. I don't want to meet you for a drink. You know what I'm saying? So it's kind of weird. Then I have this one where he's like, hi there, I saw your profile a while back. I've been trying to chat with you, but you are not returning any of my messages, which I haven't. Arturo is his name. That's an ugly name. And I have to go, you know, basically, however, thanks, Arturo. However, I'm not interested. That is why I've not responded. So, you know, it's crazy. Like, some of these guys are super boring, or just basically, like, I have one who is, like, just, like, weird. He's telling me the name brands of his clothes or what have you. And I'm not really into all of that. Like, it's really not cool, you know what I'm saying? But yeah, then I've got ones on this other app called OkCupid. Oh my god, so like, I'm going to read it to you guys, and some of them like are far-fetched. Like, okay, sign in. I think I could sign in with Facebook. Yes. Okay, so OkCupid, I actually went through because the ladies on here told me to, you know, try OkCupid out. So I was like, okay, I'm gonna do that. Let's see. So I got this one right here. His name is, what the hell is his name? His name is Pima Pika User, whatever his name is. And he's 48 years old, so he sends me a message. And this is how the message starts off with, and I'm not going to even read through the whole thing because you guys will get the gist. Army with Harmony, they drop a load on him. OPP, how can I explain it? I'll take you frame by frame it. To have y'all jump in, shall we sing it? O is for other P, is for people scratching temple. The last P, well, that's not that simple. It's sort of like another way to call a cat a kitten. It's five letters that are missing here. Did you just send me the whole fucking lyrics to OPP? Like, really? He wrote the whole fucking lyrics to OPP. So I looked at his profile picture and I was like, what is your problem, you asshole? Don't send me no stupid message from old hits. Get a life, loser. And oh yeah, go shave your nasty ass chest, you fat fuck. I mean, like, who does that? Who sends a message to anybody with OPP? So I blocked him. Then I have ones like, God, let's see. This one here, his name is, I blocked him too. I think I blocked like basically everybody on OkCupid. His name is China One Taco. Oh, and he just sends me a message out of nowhere. Oh, really exotic young beauty, such extremely attractive lips and very sexy, yummy curve. I was like, block, okay, what the fuck? People are weirdos. Then we got this young white boy who's 24 years old. he's sending me messages. I had to block him. Like, seriously, I blocked him because, what the fuck? There's a bunch of weirdos on here. Like, seriously, a bunch of freaking weirdos. And I'm trying to find the one who was like, he must have taken his profile off. Because I don't see it anymore. But basically, it was all boiling down to, you want to fuck. Like, really? Oh, my God. And then you have the other guys on here who, okay, just because you replied to them, then they ask you, where do you live? And I'm like, I live in the town of Avondale. Oh, that's good. And I'm like, why? Oh, because we can meet up and have drinks. What makes you think that I'm going to have fucking drinks with you because I replied to you? You're like 5'4". Get the fuck out of here. Like, leave me alone. Don't think that your shit is all that. Or the other guys that are, just from looking at their pictures, we got one that kind of looks like Nelson Mandela. He's got this fucking tight-ass beaded choker around his neck. Like, I really don't know. These fucking men out here are just, like, atrocious. Some of them are like, okay, get your life, boo. Get your life. It's really weird. But anyway, so let's get on to this real talk. If you want a real talk about yourself, then you can always send me an email to muffinismylovers2012@gmail.com. Make sure you put in the subject line real talk so that way I can get back to you as soon as possible. And if you want to change the names of your people in that, you can go ahead. Yeah. Oh, and also I'm going to be doing a fashion lookbook for jollychic.com. I did one for them prior, but I did get these. Look at these glasses. Like, aren't these like amazing? I freaking love these glasses by Jolly Chic. These are so dope. So dope. And I think these were like $4. These glasses are like everything. Like, I love glasses like this. These are everything. So they did come with this cute eyeglass case, and it did come in plastic inside the glass case, and it does come with a eyeglass cleaner towelette, which is awesome. But these things are everything. These glasses are like everything. Look at that. Then I also got another pair from them, which I am feeling too. These are a little bit different from me. They also came with this awesome case right here. And look at these. I love glasses that are framed like this, but these are so freaking dope. Like, do you guys see that? Tint, the see-through tint is not so dark, because I really don't like the tint to be so dark to where it looks like it's dark outside, but it gives me like a nice hue of blue. But I love these. I have never owned a pair of glasses like with this color tint, this color lens, and I really do like this color. Like, dope. They have like some that are just all gold mirrored look, and they are so inexpensive. So definitely check out jollychic.com. I will post their information below for you girls. But look, they like totally match my lipstick. Like, what? So dope. But they have some really nice inexpensive items on their website, which I am feeling. I got this awesome makeup brush set, which I think it comes with 24. I think it's 24, if I'm not mistaken. But it's a gorgeous yellow color. Look at this. Isn't this like freaking gorgeous? And of course I did use it today for my makeup for this video that I did, and I really love the brushes. It's a nice nylon like material, and what's cool about it is they are just really soft, and some of them are dense and some of them are not as dense. You don't need them all to be dense, but the brushes work really well. And I have bought brushes like this prior, like many years ago, and they were so hard. But these brushes are absolutely gorgeous. Yellow handles, silver or chrome ferrules, and yellow bristles. Really a nice brush set, and I think this was like probably like $15, $20, something like that. But you get a load of brush and a cute roll, like really a nice roll right here. So definitely check out jollychic.com. I will post their information. They have a nice plus size selection of clothing as well. And I go up like a size or two. You really don't have to go up drastically. So some of the things that I did get from there were kind of too big. But yeah, really, really cool stuff on jollychic.com. So we'll post that information for you girls and guys below. And yes, let's get into this real talk, okay? Okay, so here we go. Hi, April. I am a big fan. You always keep it real and stay on top of the beauty industry. Well, I try to. I don't really think that I do, but I try. I always see myself when I hear you talking. I have been watching you for a long time. I was so sad when your first channel was lost with all those fab hair videos. For this video, I would like to be called Candy. I am 33 years old and pregnant. I'm apologizing in advance because this is going to be long as hell and deep. I really need your advice about something that is very difficult for me to talk about, but I am trusting you for great advice. This really begins in my childhood. I had a father who could be physically abusive with over-the-top whippings and also very verbally abusive. I remember him also being abusive to my mother as a little girl as well. I also remember my mother telling my father everything I did wrong, knowing I was going to get an extreme ass whipping with a belt. Due to abuse and cheating, my mother divorced my dad when I was about 9. My mother never protected me or my sister from my father as we were kids. She knew how he was, but still my little sister and I spent every other weekend with him. One time when I was 14, I got into trouble at school and my father beat me severely with the belt. I went to the doctor a couple days later, and when I took off my clothes, my mother saw all the bruises and belt marks. She made me put my clothes back on so that the doctor would not press charges on my father. She never really cared about the abuse that I suffered my whole life. The only good thing I can say about her is that she tried to take care of us for a while. When I was 14, my mother met a man who lived at home with his mother at the age of 34, and she dated him for about a year. One weekend, she dropped us off at our grandmother's house, told us she would be back in a couple of days, but didn't show up to pick us up for about 3 weeks. She had gotten married to this man that me or my sister did not know very well. My mother then moved him into our home, and things were never the same. We could no longer go into the refrigerator or even come out of our rooms when he was around. Most of the time, we ate in our room. She stopped even talking to us except to bark orders. She acted as if she didn't want us there. People treat their dogs better than that. She kept us locked up in our rooms with no TV or radio, just stupid religious books, as she was and still is Jehovah's Witness. She has always acted like, wow, this like really is fucking with me. She has always acted like she is better than anyone who is not a Jehovah's Witness. I am not one and could not give any less of a fuck about being one. She made it clear that he, her husband, did not care for me or my sister and that she really didn't want us there. Things never changed from that. After a few months, she decided she would rather be a wife than a mother, and she took us to live with our dad so she could make her marriage work. When the abuse of me and my sister got too bad, she took us back to live with her, but under the same conditions as described above, meaning locked in the room, not able to socialize with her or her husband. I was 16, my sister was 11. She would go through our rooms, steal our stuff. She talked to us like she hated us, never spent any time with us, never taught us anything of value. If we did something she didn't like, she would take what we had, what little we had, she threw it away. Or throw it at us. But mind you, she never bought us anything. Her husband just acted like we weren't even there 99% of the time. I left her house as soon as I could at the age of 16. I couldn't take it anymore. I hated to leave my sister, but I had to go. She got pregnant. My mother got pregnant with my brother, and she treated him like gold and still treated my sister like crap. My sister also left her house as soon as she could. She also tried to prevent my sister from going to college and would not sign the papers, effectively sabotaging her life. The ironic thing is that she treated us like shit for a man who treated her like shit. He barely works. He's an alcoholic and would not give my mom $20 if she asked him for it. He really is a straight loser and has always been. There were times when my brother was a baby, my mom would come to me for diapers because he would tell her to cut up a curtain and use that for diapers. Seriously, he would only work enough to pay bills and spend the rest of the week getting drunk in his room on the couch. She has always come to me for money. I would help her if I wanted to, but sometimes I decided that she didn't deserve it. I have never asked my mother for a dime since I have left her home. Now, my sister and I have a very strained relationship with my mother. We do not like her at all. Over all these years, she has not shown any real remorse. She just fakes it. Anytime we mention the past, she would go off by condescending, minimizing the damage she caused me and my sister and act like it was nothing. She still tried to treat us like second-class citizens toward her husband, but I do not put up with it. Over the years, I have cut her out of my life for months and even a whole year. My sister and I have had some really bad arguments with her because of the way she has treated us. When it comes to our little brother, whom we love very much, she treats him so different, has protected him from being yelled at by his father. Recently, I got into it with my mother, and I told her I was done dealing with her bullshit and that I no longer want her in my life at all. The argument was because I told her she babies my brother. He cut the grass for the first time at the age of 15, and he is a big boy. Like, he weighs 260 pounds, and he's 5'9". He goes to camp during the summer. He will be 16 in October, and he has still not even rode a bike out of their neighborhood or rode the bus to school. I had a real job at the age of 14 and left our home at the age of 16, thank God. She, in return, got mad, told me my opinion doesn't matter, doesn't count, and minimized my feelings by saying that she has done a lot of stuff on her own, etc., etc. This is a reoccurring attitude with her. It has never changed. This is why I told her I don't want anything else to do with her. Mind you, I am 10 weeks pregnant after having a miscarriage last year, so I really don't need to get upset about anything. This happened about 2 weeks ago. I don't feel bad about the decision at all. In fact, I feel liberated and free. I want to ask your opinion. Do you think I should allow her into my child's life or even mine ever again? So, let's see here. What does she call herself? Candy. So Candy is 33 years old. She is 10 weeks pregnant. Her mother is basically a loser. To me, I find her mother to be a loser because, for one, you did not shield and protect your daughter. She got married to some guy. She dropped her kids off to their grandmother's house and said, I'll be back in a couple of days, and didn't come back for a few fucking weeks, 3 weeks, because she ran off and got married to some guy that her kids didn't even know. They probably met him one time, and then you moved him into your home and basically locked her kids in the fucking room and made them eat dinner, didn't have a TV or even a radio in their rooms. She did not allow them to socialize with her and her husband. That seems like a fucking Flowers in the Attic movie or book. You know what I'm saying? Like, I don't understand how women or anybody could just disassociate their children from their lives because of a fucking man or woman. Like, or some real shit. I've said this before, if you cannot accept me and my children, or basically if you cannot accept my children, then you cannot accept me. I'm not going to deal with someone who just cannot accept me as a person and who I come with. When you have children, you come with a package deal, and if the man is not man enough to accept your children into your life, then you know what? He is not worth your time being in a relationship with. Men are second-class citizens when it comes to a woman who has children. Like with myself, I have children. And if you cannot accept my kids, then you know what? You gets none of this. You gets no phone calls. You gets no attention. I'm not really going to tolerate the bullshit with the man. I'm really, really just not going to bother with it. You know what I'm saying? And I think that it's so fucked up in society where family is very important. And you never know when you're going to need your children. Your kids are number one key importance. And when you can become like a slime bucket and just disassociate yourself with your children because of some relationship that then you're in, then you really don't need to call yourself a parent. Now, as for Candy's biological father, who beat the shit out of her, I'm sorry, but I really, you know, yes, we do need to chastise our children as they are children, and we want them to grow up and be like the best that they can be, great adults, great people, what have you, yada, yada, yada. But I just find it so disheartening when a male figure, a man, could beat the crap out of their daughters. Like, I don't think that that's really, really cool. And I'm not saying they should beat the shit out of their sons either, but it just sets a different standard. You know what I mean? Like, I really think, like, okay, yes, as a father, you should give your daughter the best guidance and you should guide her onto being a woman or being a model citizen, a model person, a respectable woman. However, I don't think you should take out the belt and start beating the crap out of your daughter. Like, really, as a man, I really don't think that's appropriate. And I really don't think, like, it's appropriate for a woman, however, to beat the shit out of their daughters with a belt as well. But, you know, I understand kids these days, you gotta get an ass whooping. I mean, I grew up getting ass whooping. So, all that, oh, don't beat your kids shit. Like, listen, kids need an ass whooping sometimes. I'm sorry. I'm just going to say it like that. I'm not saying beat the shit out of them to where, like, Candy has bruises and belt marks on you. That's not a beating. That's abuse. That's totally abuse. If you're leaving markings on your children, like, you are leaving belt marks and bruises and just punch marks or whatever, scratches on your kids because you have whipped them, that's not a whooping, that's abuse, okay? And there is a fine line between abuse and a whooping. Oh, ass whooping or punishment is one thing, but when you are leaving marks on your kid, that is totally wrong. And if you as a man are beating your kids and you're beating your daughter and you're leaving and marks on her, that to me just, like, really kind of brings me, like, okay, wait a minute. You're whipping your daughter. Are you whipping your daughter? Or are you whipping your daughter and you're thinking of your wife or your girlfriend or whoever you think you have this baby with? Like, are you taking that out on them? Like, I don't know. Like, I remember as a kid growing up, I got quite a few ass whoopings. And yes, I did have some markings on me as well from the belt. Okay, so nobody's parents are perfect. And when I did go to school, to gym, best believe Child Protection Services was called to my house. They came to my mother's house the next day because I had belt marks, belt with whelps all over my legs. So you don't want to leave markings on your kids. You don't want to get involved with that type of thing. But if you're wondering, you know, like, should you be bothered with your mother? Should you allow her into your kids' life? Here's the thing. At the end of the day, that's still your mother. And at the end of the day, you both need to respect each other. However, you don't have to kiss nobody's ass. If you feel like she is not a priority in your life and she has mistreated you and your sister, then me personally, I'm not really going to involve her in my own child's life. I'm not going to bring my child around. I'm not going to be kissing ass or anything like that. That's one thing that I'm not going to do. You know what I'm saying? I'm just not going to do that. No. But if she wants to come around in her own, for her own good, if she wants to come around because she cares, then allow her to, but kind of put some restrictions on things. Don't allow her to watch your child. And I say this, like, don't allow her to watch your child because you already know as an adult how things were when you grew up. So I basically would not leave my child over her house. I wouldn't do that. And I wouldn't go into her home with my child. I wouldn't put myself and my baby in an uncomfortable situation. If she wants to see your child, then let her know. She is more than welcome to come over. However, put some restrictions. Let her know in advance. There's not going to be any disrespect. There's not going to be any mistreat. If you can't respect me as a human being and as a woman and as your daughter, then I would prefer you not to come around. You really need to put some restrictions and guides on, you know what I'm saying, rules on the relationship, because she didn't have any type of rules on the relationship. She kind of basically locked you in your room, you and your sister in a room, and dealt with her husband because that's who she felt was in importance to her. And here's the thing, you have your own family to deal with. And me personally, sometimes in life you have to leave people alone and just let them be who they are. And I've kind of done that with my own family members as well, because I'm not going to allow you to stress me out and condescend me and disrespect me. And as much as I love my own mother as well, we just don't see eye to eye, and she kind of goes back and forth with my eldest son, who's 24. She goes back and forth with him, and she basically talks about me. She kind of puts me down a lot. You know, my son does come back and tell me these things. She puts me down a lot, and I think it has a lot to do with who I am as a person and who she is as a person. We are total opposites, you know what I mean? She would rather me be more like her, which is just more shelled, not having any friends and just not doing anything and just going to work and that's it. And basically she just feels like, you're 42 years old, what are you doing on the internet? Like, okay, I'm 42 years old, that does not mean I'm dead. So she doesn't really agree with the things that I do. And really, I don't bother anybody too much on YouTube. I do what I like to do on YouTube, and it's not disturbing. It is my life, and it is what I enjoy doing, and it's a hobby for me. So I really don't think that what I do on YouTube is hurtful to anyone, but she doesn't agree with it. So, you know what I'm saying? There's really, like, we don't really see eye to eye in a lot of things. And on top of that, I really don't appreciate the fact that you are just, like, badgering me to my son. That is your grandson. And why would you do that? Like, why would you do that? So I don't really talk to her often. You know, when I do talk to her, I try. But she's very, just, like, very, she's set in her own ways. She really doesn't care for my other four children too much. And I say this because whenever I say something about them to her, oh, that's great. They're doing good. Like, those are your grandchildren. But so I keep away from her. She's in New York. I'm in Arizona. I keep away from her. I keep my personal life to myself with her. I don't really share too much with her. If she calls me or if I call her, it's basically a really short conversation. I really don't kick up too much information because, for what? She really doesn't care. As for my father, we have, like, this really great relationship with each other, and we're really open with each other. And his wife is really, really just very nurturing to me and my children. Him and his wife are very nurturing to me and my children, which I appreciate a lot. So I can totally understand how Candy feels. You know, as a child, I have grown up with a very strict mother. I have gotten a lot of ass whippings where I've had markings on me, and also badgered as a teenager with certain things that my mom said. So it's not like we have the best relationship in the world, but I love her to death because she is my mother and I respect her. I would never disrespect her. And when she does come out of pocket, meaning she comes out of mouth to me, I do kind of have to put her in her place, because even though you're my mother, you're not going to disrespect me. I'm not going to allow you to disrespect me. So I keep my distance from her. And my children have their own values and they have their own feelings towards her. They just feel basically like my four children, not all five of them, not my eldest, but my other four. They just feel like my mother, that she doesn't like them because she doesn't send them anything. She doesn't do anything for them. She doesn't call and ask about them. She doesn't know their names. She doesn't know their birthdays, which is really like, okay, come on now. How do you not know your grandkids' name? But it's true. It's truth be said. My mom does not know their birthdates or their names. She's asked me this in a text message. Please send me the kids' names and birthdates. You know what I'm saying? Like, okay, really? This was a year ago, so really. My youngest is almost 9. How do you not fucking remember your grandkids' name? So I can totally relate to how she feels. You know what I'm saying? Totally relate to how she feels. So I keep my distance and I keep my kids at bay and I keep them at a distance. You know what I'm saying? It is what it is. I'm not going to force my children on her, and I'm not going to force myself on her either. So even though it may hurt to some extent, you know what? It's for my own sanity. I'm not going to sit here and stress it out. Just because you're my parent doesn't mean that I got to stress myself out because you don't want to speak to me. If that's the life you want to live and that's the life you choose, then hey, that's cool. And the same thing goes when my mom had my sister with her newer boyfriend. She treated her like gold. She did the same thing. She treated her like gold. You know what I'm saying? She allowed her to do way more. She didn't beat on her. She didn't punish her like that. She treated her a lot different from me. So I totally get it. I totally can understand where you're coming from, Candy, and I can totally relate to it. So for me, my personal experience, because the way I handle things with my mother, and I know what you're going through, and it's kind of like the same thing, I would leave her the fuck alone. You know what I'm saying? Just like I leave mine alone. I don't really socialize with her, you know. She didn't call me on my birthday. She sent me a text message the next day and basically was like, oh, I forgot it was your birthday. Happy birthday. And that was it. You know what I'm saying? So I just keep my distance because I feel like this. My life is a lot happier being stressed and drama free. And I'm not going to allow you as a person, regardless if you are my biological mother, to bring me down and to chastise me and to talk about me and to badger me. If you want to do that, then do that, and do that on the other side of the United States while I'll be over here. So me personally, I would just leave her the fuck alone and continue on with my life. you introducing her to your child is not going to make your relationship any better. She's probably still not going to care because she has her own child still who she treats like a baby. Same scenario. So I wouldn't really even give much thought into it. I would carry on with my life. Who needs to be stressed? Regardless, family is family. Yes, that's great. If you have a family member, that's great to you. But family can also tear you down. So I just try to steer away from all the extra drama from anybody. Like, seriously, from just about anybody. Okay? Whether it be mother, father, brother, or anything like that. I really just don't deal with any type of bullshit in my life. And that's just the bottom line. So, yes. Let's get on to the next real talk. Okay. Hey, April, I love you and your Real Talk video so much, and I know you are the perfect person to give me advice on this situation. I'm going to get straight to it, and I apologize in advance for how long it is. Names have already been changed, so you can call me Denise. My sister Nicole and I are 16 months apart, her being older, and have always been very close. I've seen Nicole waste 3 years and get hurt by a guy she really cared for once before she finally got over him. Then a few months later, in October 2014 to be exact, she ended up reconnecting with the guy she met back in 2011, but had lost contact with him. We'll call him Kenny. At the time, Kenny was living in another state with his father, but would visit his mother where we live at on the holidays. After talking for a while, my sister and them both confessed that they had feelings for each other and began dating. That was in January of 2015. Everything appeared to be good for a while. Kenny was a gentleman and very different from her last boyfriend, which was a relief to me and my mom. Then in the summer of 2015 came, and I noticed Nicole talking a lot about Kenny having an issue with marijuana. Now, I'm not against weed at all, but he would smoke so much that he was hardly ever sober, and Nicole was worried that it was becoming an addiction that would lead him onto other drugs. She wanted him to stop, and he told her that he did. Fast forward to the spring of 2016. My sister Nicole and Kenny are still together. Throughout the time they've been dating, I noticed a few things about Kenny that I didn't like. For example, he would make rude comments about my sister's hair and makeup or her outfit. She told me about how he'd always make comments about her being dark-skinned, which she is not. Nicole also told me about a conversation that they had where he said to her, the darker a girl is, the uglier she is. Being a dark-skinned girl myself, that didn't sit right with me. I often found my sister saying things like, Kenny would kill me if I wore that. Kenny wants me to get my nails done. Kenny doesn't want me going out without him. It surprised me a little, but not at all too much, because I often tell my sister that she's a pleaser and always puts her boyfriend's wants or needs before anything else. Then in May, Nicole and I went to visit Kenny. At this point, he was no longer living with his dad, but with his mom's best friend, who he refers to as his aunt. Well, we'll call her Casey. Casey was very rude to my sister Nicole without even ever having met her. She was jealous of how close Kenny and Nicole was and did not want him to talk to her. She even went as far as trying to set him up with another girl, claiming that my sister Nicole was a Ford Focus and the other girl was a Mustang. Meanwhile, Kenny let Casey disrespect my sister Nicole and said absolutely nothing about it. Well, Nicole got tired of it and called Kenny's aunt a bitch, not to her face, but to Kenny. He didn't like that and told her to respect Casey, which caused a huge argument between them two. Of course, when she told me about this, I didn't like it. In my opinion, if he loves Nicole so much, he shouldn't let Casey, his aunt, disrespect my sister. But Nicole didn't think of it as a big deal, so I left it alone. Then around mid-May, he comes to live with his mother permanently. Kenny does. This is when things got a little shaky. He would ignore my sister's calls and texts, but then turn around and be on Snapchat. So one day, towards the end of June, Kenny and Nicole and I smoked a little weed. Although it wasn't my sister's first time doing it, she completely tripped out. Kenny and I were fine, though. She was hallucinating and everything. Well, our mother found out and was furious that Kenny had brought weed into her home because my mother does not approve of it at all, which we all already knew. My mom ended up texting him saying that she was disappointed in him for what he did because she thinks of him as a son. The next few days, Kenny doesn't answer Nicole's calls or texts. She thinks he's mad at her over the text my mother sent Kenny. Then he finally calls my sister and says he couldn't talk to her because his phone was dead. Damn, dead for days? I didn't believe it for a second, but I kept my mouth shut and didn't say anything. Then less than a week later, Kenny breaks up with my sister. This is completely devastated. My sister is completely devastated, but the very next day, Kenny calls her wanting to go to the movies. She goes and they get back together. The next day, Nicole can't reach him again. She's going crazy trying to get in touch with him. When I finally told her, if he really wants to be together, like he said, let his actions speak instead of the words. So she finally came to terms with the fact that Kenny's playing games with her and all the tea came out. She told me how he's stolen money from her purse, She told me that Kenny has stolen money from her purse, the presents that he supposedly bought her, actually, she bought herself, that he's now trying cocaine, that he's returned her birthday present in order to buy drugs for himself, and the fact that he's admitted having feelings for another girl. Nicole seemed to be doing pretty well until Kenny called her a couple days ago, acting as if nothing was wrong. She didn't question him about ignoring her for 2 weeks, and he didn't even offer an explanation. After talking to him, my sister immediately began to make excuses for him and everything he's done again. She even told him she was thinking about not going on vacation with me so that she could spend time with him. Now, before anyone tries to say I should stay out of my sister's business, this is all stuff she is telling me. I'm writing because she asked me to. I've already told her that she can do without, and she wants to do what? I've already told my sister that she can do what she wants to do in this situation. But if she gets hurt again, she has to accept the fact that she has put herself in that position to be possibly hurt. I really don't want her to waste some of her best years of her life on a guy who isn't sure if he wants to fuck with her or not. April, please tell Nicole what you think. Is she wasting her time? Is he wasting her time? Should she stay with him? I've told her my opinion and we'd love to hear yours. Denise and Nicole. So basically, Denise and Nicole, they are 16 months apart. Nicole is the older sister who is basically with some fucking loser she has wasted 3 years with. So he wants to break up with her, go back to her. He got his aunt disrespecting her. He lives at home with his mother and his sister or his best friend or whoever. He just lives wherever he can fucking live. He has control issues. She's basically, Kenny don't like this, Kenny don't like that. He's disrespecting dark-skinned women by saying the darker you are, the uglier you are. He doesn't like her wearing this, he doesn't like her wearing that, he doesn't like her going outside without him, but he will ignore her calls, tell her that his phone has been dead for days. I'm sorry, but if you don't call me for days, I'm really not going to believe the excuse that your phone is dead. Then you're using cocaine, you're returning birthday presents that you bought me to buy drugs, you break up with me, you tell me that you're interested in somebody else, and then she goes back and forth with him. Is he wasting her time? Yes, she's wasting her own fucking time. I'm sorry, but here's the thing. If you don't want to fuck with me, then you just don't want to fuck with me. I am not about to put my life on the line for some motherfucker who wants to use drugs, disrespect me, tell me what to wear, tell me how to act, tell me what to think, tell me where to go, tell me what to do, and then don't call me for a few days. Ignore my calls and my text messages, and then be on other social media. However, if you keep continuing to fucking chase old dude down and chase behind him, then he's just going to continue to do the same shit over and over and over to you. Now, I'm not telling you to stop chasing him and allow him to chase you. I'm just telling you this for future reference for the next boyfriend you meet. And I'm saying the next boyfriend you meet because the one that you're with right now, Kenny, he's a loser, okay? Let him fucking go. He's not worth your fucking time. He's a cokehead. He's a motherfucking crackhead. If you ask me, coke is crack. He's a crackhead. Now he's experimenting with new drugs. He's allowing his family members to disrespect you. I mean, like, really, is the dick that fucking good? I'm just saying, is it really that good? There is really no good dick in the world to allow yourself to belittle your own self and to allow someone to walk all over you. But, okay, I will tell you this. Dick may be good. It may be good dick. Okay, that's great and all. But at the end of the day, 5 minutes have passed. Okay, so my memory card got full. So like I was saying, okay, yes, it's great to have some good dick. But after the 5 minutes or 10, 15, 20 minutes, 30 minutes, hour if you're lucky, is over with. Do you think about your own self-worth? Like, damn, I'm putting up with this dickhead who has just like really great dick. For what? Like, you know what I'm saying? I'm sorry, but I think my self-worth is way more important than some dickhead dude who doesn't care about anybody but themselves. So, Denise, listen to me. Nicole, listen to me. Men come a dime a dozen. Women come a dime a dozen. It is always great to be in a relationship with somebody. However, the relationship has to be 100%. Nobody is perfect. Nobody is perfect, and the relationship is not going to be perfect. However, there are some things in this relationship that is so toxic that even if you wanted it to be perfect, it couldn't. Now, when another person in the relationship is making it toxic and is not even trying to work on anything, why bother staying the fuck around in the relationship? Like you said, your sister was doing so well without Kenny not contacting her for a couple of weeks. And then once they got back together, the bullshit started to arise. The nonsense started to rise. Stop making excuses for Kenny, okay, Nicole? Stop making excuses for him. We don't make excuses for men. We don't make excuses for anything. If it is what it is what the fuck it is. And at the end of the day, you're the one that's making excuses for somebody that you're making yourself look like a jackass. Now, I'm going to explain this. You're making excuses for Kenny, but you're also making excuses for yourself. And while you're making excuses for Kenny, you're also making yourself look like a total jackass. Why would you want to make excuses for someone who does not give a fuck about you? If he can return a gift that he bought you for your birthday to make himself feel better so he can have some powder up his nose, then he is really not worthy of your time, okay? Second of all, if he can allow himself to come out of his mouth and tell you he is interested in another female, what makes you think that he wants to really be with you 100%, okay? If he can allow anybody in his household, family member, friendship, what the fuck ever, to disrespect his girlfriend, then what makes you feel like you are that much of an importance to him? You are worth so much more. Now, I don't know you personally, but I would consider myself to feel like this. I am a woman, and I may not be perfect. However, I do not deserve a man to walk all over me, to use me, to be a bum, to talk shit about my skin color or me as a person. I do not deserve this. Regardless of my flaws, okay, nobody deserves anybody to be kicking dirt on them. So yes, like I always say, it's great to be in a relationship and it's great to have love and it's great to have companionship. However, you need to be real picky these days of what motherfuckers you choose to do it with, because them same people that you may want to have companionship with ain't worth even fucking breathing on, or let alone if they was on fire to piss on. Okay? I'm sorry, but this nigga right here needs to be bye, Felicia, bye. Goodbye, okay? Find time for yourself, because it seems like you don't even love yourself enough. Had you loved yourself enough, you wouldn't be with this loser ass motherfucker. There are plenty of men out there. Sometimes they are a little bit harder to find the right ones, but I guarantee you, when you let go of one that ain't worth shit, another one will come along that's worth something, okay? Trust me when I tell you this. So just take that into consideration and let this bad breath, let him go and get yourself a good breath of fresh air. It is always nice to have a nice fresh breath of air, okay? When karma is ready, karma will serve him a nice dish of karma. However, life is short. Never allow anyone to make your life miserable. It is a short life, okay? And I always say, live it to the fullest and enjoy it, all right? I have been miserable for many years in my life. And I refuse to let any man make my shit miserable ever the fuck again. If I like old dude that I'm, and I say old dude, but if I like this dude that I've been dealing with, like, you know, just conversing with, and we've been going out with each other and stuff, if I like him enough, then, you know, I'll allow him into my world. But if I start feeling some type of way about him, then you know what? It's not really worth it, because I'm not going to allow anybody to shade me and to make me feel shaded and to make me feel some type of way. The first, now I'm not going to say the first fuck up, but if I start feeling some type of way about you and you start showing me signs, I'm really not going to fuck with you no more. I'm just going to leave you alone. You know what I mean? Because my life is too short, and I've already been through enough. So regardless of how cute you are, how pretty your eyes may be, listen, I got to live my life, and I'm not going to allow you to disrupt it or make it miserable, regardless of how your day may be. So, yes, Nicole, it is time to move on and to leave this guy alone. He's toxic, and toxic is not really good. It's poison. And you're starting to pick up his bad habits by making up excuses for him. And that is a bad fucking habit. And why would you want to be with a crackhead? Okay? Like, seriously, who wants to be with a fucking crackhead? I'm just saying. So, yes, my loves. Yes. I know I only did two today. I was really trying to do three. But it seems like I went like a little overboard. Like, I think I did good for the day, because I had to put in my memory card, so I know it's like at least 45 minutes, right? So, yes. And I'm going to go and pick up my grandson right now. I'm always going to pick up my grandson. We love to hang out. We're going to go back to Jubilee, this little place for toddlers from 0 to 5 years old. He freaking loved it, so this is his third time going now. So me and Tati, we just sit there and we just let him go. We watch him play, and he has an amazing time. So yes, I'm going to go pick up my daughter so that we can take him there and have like an amazing day. And yeah, so on that note, I will see you girls and guys really, really soon. And stay diva and divalicious. Make sure you leave your comments below, and see you in my next video.